now we'll do a short quiz to really test your command of Mandarin.
Okay, okay.
Yeah. Okay.
No stress, right?
No prize money also. Yeah. Okay. First one.
Yeah.
Okay. Avocado.
Avocado. Can I buy through that?
It's actually early.
Early? Oh, yeah. Okay.
Heng Sui Kiet.
Heng Sui Kiet's name. Not Lee Hsien Loong.
Lee Hsien Loong easy, right? Everybody knows.
Chen. Heng Sui Kiet. No, it's not Wang. It's Wang.
It's Wang.
Wang something. Wang. Wang. Why this goes up and he's easy?
It's okay.
Wang. No, I only know China's Wang Jie.
Oh, Wang Rui.
Wang
Rui
Jie. Wang Rui Jie.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Wang Rui Jie.
Wang Rui Jie.
Meme.
Meme. Ah. Oh, wow. Meme. Mimi.
Moing.
Moing. Okay, wow. Where do you guys find all this English?
Facebook.
Facebook.
Oh, I thought it's Lian Shu, no meh?
No.
It's not.
Okay, okay. Lian Shu.
It's Lian Shu. In Chinese, what they say in China?
They use Facebook. Because they can pronounce it very. Facebook, yeah. They use Facebook.
Today, as in today newspaper. Mm. Yeah. Mm.
Today newspaper.
Yeah.
今日头条.
Close, close.
That's today's headline.
Close, close, close.
今日报纸. Oh, this is direct translation. Yeah, 今日报纸. Alright. Okay. 今日报. 今日报.
How many marks will you give yourself?
I feel like I was in my secondary school when I was trying to pass my Chinese. Okay. So I think I barely passed. Yeah, thank you, teacher.
You went to China, you mentioned, right? For an entrepreneurship program. Yes. And you were there for a 1 year internship. Mm. So maybe you can share initially when you went there, you know, what were the struggles you were facing, trying to communicate in Mandarin.
In the first few months, I had difficulty understanding the language. They spoke in, the accent were very different. And in Beijing also, they like to use, like, for instance, what, right? W-H-A-T. It's called sha in Beijing. But in the south, people say shema. So if you come to Singapore, you talk to your friends, they all use the word shema for, like, what. And that was something very different. It took me a bit of time to actually try to understand that. But eventually, at the end of the whole internship, I was really quite fluent. And everyone said I was very 接地气, which means you are really a local now, you're localized. Being bilingual allows me to communicate with different markets of people. Like, I have no problems communicating with the Caucasians, the Europeans, and even the Chinese. So I felt very proud to be a Singaporean back then.